Hello and welcome to my reaction to another K-pop guide. Today we have a big one. This is a helpful guide to G-Dragon, GD 21 of BIGBANG by the channel Vivi Puldana. Yeah, otherwise the 2021 version was like, you know, end of 2020, sure. They always do that, kind of like the games, you know, like FIFA 2021 or something, and you know, it's like from 2020. It's always funny, but yeah, 45 minutes, it's a long one. So it's a long video. I should mention I'm recording this very early. It's like my first recording of the day. It's like still 6 a.m. So if I don't seem to wake up and if the lighting is pretty bad, that's why. But since it's a very long video and, you know, with all the talking I might do, it might take like an hour. This is, you know, just the time where I can record it. So yeah, sorry about that. But yeah, so I've done like an overall guide to BIGBANG. It was pretty awesome. A lot of info. Really, I want to check out a lot more BIGBANG. And so G-Dragon is obviously like the leader and just clearly, like the big name, not only in BIGBANG but overall in K-pop, seems very well known. I've checked out one of his solo songs right now. That's more than that, but I will do more. So I figured I'm really like a fan of the guy, and BIGBANG a lot. Might as well check this out. This channel seems to have like a guide for the other members as well. I see one for Top over there. I might do them as well if you guys want to. You just tell me in the comments. The classic YouTuber thing: the more people tell me they want me to do something, the more likely I am to do it. But yeah, G-Dragon, pretty awesome. This channel also has like a more in-depth guide to BIGBANG. Right now they have like 2 or 4 parts of like about 45 minutes, covering like a couple years at a time. That might be interesting to do, like maybe not right away, but later on whenever I do a lot more song. Yeah, maybe. So right now I'll do this guide of G-Dragon, and later I'll do more songs, and then maybe I'll do another of the solo guide. But yeah, should be interesting. As always, link in the description for the original video. The link to this person's channel, the link to my Twitter, Discord, Twitch, and Bilibili if you want to follow me, the link to my stream event, of course, if you want to request any reaction, K-pop, Utaite, Vocaloid, YouTuber, singer, you just donate any amount, tell me what video to check out, and I'll check it out for sure, compared to in the comments where I can't do every single suggestion, there's just too many. Yeah, with K-pop, there's literally too many. Like, every day I get so much more. It's like, I have like a tab with like all, like a tab group with all the suggestions, and like everything is so small I can't literally tell what anything is until I click on it because I can't read the name. Okay, so yeah, let's see what G-Dragon is about, outside just making great music. Yeah, here we go. English translation of his name is Kwon Ji-young. G-Dragon is such a cool name though. 88. Damn, too fast. I need to pay attention. Yeah, the dragon, okay.
그냥 저한테는 좀 남들한테는 그냥 행운의 숫자 같은 거 있잖아요.
Sounds right.
그런 거예요. 그냥 제가 88년생.
Okay, fair enough.
88일생이라서.
August 18.
좀 미신 같은 건데 8을 어렸을 때부터 되게 좋아해서.
I don't think I have a number like that.
좋고. 메비우스 D 같기도 하고 인피니트 같기도 하고.
Yeah, is it. So this guy is the... Yeah, okay. We'll have to do pause. It's not just because of it, so it's because, yeah. Tell him this tree at 4 or 5 years old, okay? Damn. Cute show, I guess, children show. He also was coming into drama, he also worked as a child model. Debuted in 1984, group... so fast. Little Rura, okay.
네, 저는 권지용이라고 합니다.
네, 그리고.
Okay, that's cute. 6 years old. Well, already quite a hip hop style dance, yeah. Ji-young was personally scouted by the founder, SM founder, Lee So-man, and he was the SM trainee for 5 years. Okay.
저희 신입생 애들 처음에 입학했을 때 이제 자기 그 장기를 보여주는 시간이 있었거든요. 네, 제가 찍은 건데 지용이가 때 춤을 잘 춰가지고.
Yeah, clearly he could dance right away. He left the SM after 5 years of training. Didn't really have an idea of what to do with me. Recalls G-Dragon Complex 2013. That's kind of a shame. Then 5 years, and I mean, I wouldn't say it's for nothing because he got the training and all that, so he can just use that somewhere else, but yeah. Fell in love with hip-hop after discovering Wu-Tang Clan. I listened to it so many times, I'm not fluent in English now, but back then, I'm not fluent in English now? isn't it? But back then I didn't know anything. I would write down the lyrics to Cream in Cram, not translating it, but phonetically writing out each word. I didn't know what they were saying, so I would just write everything down as I heard it. I'd reset it and imitate it like that. That's how I started to write my own raps. That album pretty much started everything for me. It's a very meaningful album. Interesting. I haven't heard it. I know who the Wu-Tang Clan is. Not really what I listen to, so I never heard it. Writing lyrics when he was in elementary school.
The 첫 번째 오디션 같은 거였지. 공책을 꺼내서 뒤적뒤적 하더라고요. 그래서 그게 뭐니? 그게 뭐니? 했더니 자기가 평상시에 써놨던 랩.
So hustling from like a young age.
되게 의아했어요. 초등학생이 보통 그림을 쓰고 막 이러는데.
Yeah, it just seems like that's how I can put it. You know, he was destined for this. That's really what it seems like. Started so young. I guess his parents put him into like such a show at 5 or something. And yeah, then he just like was so focused on that, always what he does, music, music, music. Become the youngest rapper to debut, 13. I feel like now these days, you know. Sounds okay. The first time when he used the stage name G-Dragon. G-Dragon hasn't seen or seen Gino-san, recommended to go to YHS, YG Founder. Became 20 for another 5 years. Okay, damn.
정말 천밥이었기 때문에.
So overall, he wasted 10 years. Well, wasted. Spent 10 years of training? Like, I feel like 5 years already was enough.
뭐, 예를 들어서, 매니저분께서 픽업을 하러 10시까지 yeah. 어느 역으로 나와라.
1000. Why was a small company. We didn't have a good support system for his journey as of today, yeah. 5 years of like doing nothing.
그 역으로 10시까지 영배랑 나가 있어요. 근데 매니저 형은 다른 가수들 챙기다가 잊어버려요. 그럼 오후 2시가 돼요. 2시까지 저희는 역에서 기다리는 거예요. 전화를 해요. 안 받아요. 할 수 없이 제철 타고 사무실로 가요.
Might pose a lot. I mean, I've got a lot of comments about like I pose too much, or people saying that it's okay to pose a lot because you have to hear what I say rather than just, you know, watch the video. So yeah, I'm gonna pose a lot. I just better so I can say what I want to say when I have to say it. So I was gonna say like maybe yeah, in a way like spending like overall 10 years like wasting time during this time maybe he had like a lot of ID, and that's how you know like they were ready for Big Bang and just like slamming out so many great music. They were like steaming and preparing and just ready to unleash. Yeah. I just forgot about you, motherfucker. Spent all their teens cleaning and organizing the practice room after other artists before they can use them for their own practice. Damn.
Fucked up. 저희의 하루의 일과의 시작은 걸레질, 바닥 걸레질, 창문. 그때는 뭐 이런 것도 없어요. 뭐라고 하지? 뿌리고 그냥
Newspaper.
신문지 갖고 닦는 거예요. 닦고 먼지 줍고 한 시간이 걸리면 연습 두 시간 하고.
Enough money to eat properly.
가수분들이 내려와요. 그러면 자리를 내줘야죠.
Damn.
저랑 태양이는 구경하고 있다가 가수분들 나가면.
Literally, like most of the K-pop group, it's like, you know, came for the bottom and now we are here. I think there's a better descriptive for it.
또 지하철 시간이 있기 때문에 또 이제 뒷정리해요. 다시 또 닦고 걸레질하고 다 옮기고 막 이래저래 정리하다가 집에 오면은 12시 1시가 되죠.
Also another thing I want to mention, man, sorry I'm posing way too much. I mean, it's okay to pose, but I'm doing way too much. His look is nothing like now or other time. Like, it's interesting to see the transformation. He looks like such a nice, quiet boy, yeah? And then, like, in little stuff, he's such a badass looking guy.
그럼 잠을 자고 새벽 6시에 일어나서 학교를 가요. 학교에서 졸죠, 당연히.
Yeah.
혼나죠, 그럼. 성적은 또 안 나오죠.
Understandable.
집에서는 또 뭐라고 하죠. 학교에서는 또 뭐라고 하죠. 다시 또 계속 그 반복이었던 것 같아요, 연습생 때는.
Dragon featured in YG Family release in 2001-2003. So he did do some stuff then. Okay, that sounds pretty alright. Oh, Sin. That's that Wu One Team. Okay, take the moves. I mean, I feel like I don't really like his voice for like when he's young there. I feel like yeah, it just doesn't do it for me. But clearly, like, you know, Odi had like that, the flow and just the vibe. So clearly, yeah, he was like ready for this shit. So I guess he did perform sometimes, just nothing for himself, like no group for himself or yeah, on other people's stuff. Huh? 8, 19, 2006, Yejong debuted as leader of BIGBANG. Okay, well, yeah, 2006, huh? And then the revolution started. The world domination started. Is it world domination? Is BIGBANG like that big a sort of Korea? Yeah, this sounds good. Live songs that put BIGBANG on top. I haven't reacted to that yet, but I think this is the next one that people really want me to check out, so I guess Lies will be the next one I do. Composed songs Lies become a national 8 in South Korea. Nice. Top Korean music chart for 7 consecutive weeks, breaking the record by Sotaji and Boys. Alright. Sotaji is someone I need to check out as well. Them. One of the best. Too fast. I mean, seriously, how is anyone supposed to beat this? One of the best songwriters of Give Up. Fair enough. Songwriting. I might understand, yeah, I guess so. Last Farewell composed by Jürgen knocked Lies and top chart for 8 consecutive weeks on November 27. So they beat the record instantly. It sounds alright. It's interesting I'm much more like soft at this compared to like the rap style he was doing. The current person we don't know which dragon is in BIGBANG is, damn, okay. So it really blew up right away. Awesome. That's catchy though. Bang, bang. Aru Aru. I was about to say, why is Aru Aru? Composed by Dragon, released on August 8th, 2008. My favorite song from them so far. I've listened to it at least 100 times. Not exaggerating. Dun, dun. Such a good song. Even bigger hits than Lies and proof that BIGBANG is more than one hit group. Yeah. Well, they already had a second hit, so. So good. Such music and music experts choose Day by Day as one of the best idol songs in the past 20 years. I don't know that. Dun, adu, adu. 10 years since its release, Aru Aru still charts on Melon. Wow. That's awesome. You know, that's a legendary song, basically. Tonight EP 2011. Tonight, the song of the month of March 2011. Love Song, the song of the month of April 2011. Highest paid idol group in 2011. Best worldwide act, award from the 2011 MTV Europe Music Awards. 39% of worldwide votes. Okay, so yeah, I guess they're a big worldwide. Best fan, award from the 2012 MTV Italy Total Request Live Award. Okay, just a bunch of accolades. First keeper to be featured artist of the month. Yeah, okay. Most searched celebrity at the end of 2011 alongside GFRIEND and. No, was it GFRIEND? Girl Generation IO. Cool. Cool. Alive EP 2012, Blue topped all Korean music chart as soon as it's released. Back Song of the Month on February 2012. Fantastic Baby, which I've reacted to, picked at number 2 but became number 1 later in another music chart, in all Korean music chart, Song of the Month on March 2012. And Monster swept all Korean music chart as soon as it's released without any promotion. Awesome. Featured on the music twice. Every country cage to a demand show show where we to be added to the show in some cities, including Anaheim, New Jersey, London, Singapore, and Hong Kong. Okay, okay, then. Made album 26th. Like, seriously, I'm just not supposed to read all this in like a second. Maybe it's like you're not meant to read it. Loser swept all Korean music charts as soon as it's released. Bang 3 top chart in June 2015. If You topped all charts in July 2015. Lesson Fall in Love topped all charts in August. Okay. I mean, they are massive. Winning music award each month they release new music. Awesome. About 10 years on their debut, so it's like popularity isn't fading. Cutely Counts of Months, the top chart in this game, everything. 172 songs listed under his name, he earns around 1 million each year just from royalties. Awesome. Main producer, composer, Lake Writer, and BIGBANG. Besides BB, he also produced for his members solo, as well as for himself and YG Junior groups. Awesome. It's kind of like a rap monster in BTS. G-Dragon is one of the best solo artists in K-pop since 2009. 2018, certified executive from famous K-pop companies in music industry chose G-Dragon as the best solo artist. Wow. Like, for MC, I checked that so far. You know, for me, it's like between G-Dragon and IU, I guess. 2009. Literally way too fast, come on. 2009, it's 5 million digital sales, sold 200,000 copies, best album of 2009. Oh, I guess they just put it on screen after a while. Between 2 and 3 and 4. I feel that she got more from the solo stuff, yeah. He has really told me how much like variety of music genre he's doing in his solo stuff. Nice. 2012, One of a Kind, Best Hip Hop and Rap Song of 2012, Best Male Artist of 2012. 2013, Coup d'État, collab with Missy Elliott, Sky Federa, Dilpo, Boa, Boys Noise, Artist of the Year 2013. Don't know any of these names. Alright. International. Boy. This outfit though. This like rainbow outfit in the background. 2017 charted number 1 at 46 countries on iTunes, one of the best selling albums online, 760,000 copies sold in China. Untitled 2014 got back on Korean music charts. Back. Opposite one of my reaction to one of his songs on Bilibili. So he didn't get a ton of view, but I guess he is popular in China. I need to put more BIGBANG over there. Alright. Damn. Dude was just absolute like trash here. But you can tell the energy though. Awesome. Two World Tour, One of a Kind in 2013 and Act 3 Motte into his hands in. 9 countries, 13 cities, and 2013, getting a total of 570,000 fans. That feel though, that look. It really goes crazy with looks. Looks like a nice car, actually. Production of the tour costed 3.5 million, making it the largest scale in coin history in 2013. Alright. Breaking record upon record. Fair enough. Directed by Trace Payne and Stacey Walker, previously worked on Michael Jackson, This Is It Tour. I don't know the tour, but, you know, working with Jackson is obviously a massive thing. Also the first Korean artist to... Stop it! To have a Dome 2 in Japan, largest arena with capacity of 55,000, then I can't speak today, so it's, yeah, okay. With Kane as he injured his leg during tour, but still continued the one-of-a-kind tour, performed with injured leg only when he went to military in 2018, he was able to receive proper treatment surgery. He received a letter of aid from Netizen, a new toxic K-pop fan, as they believe he received privileged treatment as top star. I feel like, in the first place, the fact that so many of this K-pop group members that are literally like massive celebrity still have to do it, to me means that they don't have like that much of a treatment. Like, I feel like I would have expected that they get exemption from it with the money and the money making machine and all that that they're bringing for the country. So I'm just surprised that they even have to go. But at the same time, yeah, I'm sure you can imagine that like they might have some special treatment. I mean, everybody might know who G-Dragon is, I guess. Even if himself like wouldn't want that, he wanted it like everybody else. It's very possible, yeah. Understandable. Kind of weird to go into an army with a broken leg. Oh, broken leg. Alright. Fair enough. Netizen. I've never seen it written like that. Netizen. That's why I was kind of confused. He's still doing the dance though. Okay. I thought he was just going to sing because he has a cane, but no, he's still trying to dance. Respect. Largest concert to ever connected by a Korean solo artist, attended by 654,000 people. Damn. Sick. So basically, he has like largest record, not as Big Bang, but as a solo, as himself, basically. So the question is like, is it bigger than Big Bang in, as a solo artist? That's interesting. And he goes through so many looks, trendsetter. This is like you need to try to create something new. When you're kind of being chased and everything you do goes so well, you develop the sickness and a sense of need to constantly do something different. Yeah, you guys told me once again, there's so many different genres of music, which I'm looking forward to see, so I understand, yeah. That man can be satisfied, chase the dream, never ending.
Trend setting.
Band 6.
I like to use the word an astronaut.
An astronaut.
You know, because astronaut travels and they go places that no one else goes, you know, so... I like to say he's an astronaut in what he's doing right now.
That's a good way to put it then, yeah. I like the analogy. Yeah, the sound is solo, yeah. It's not my fault. I don't know if you guys can hear anything, but I can.
Sometimes he even reminds okay, bye-bye.
Trace Payne and Stacey Walker directed One of a Kind 2 in 2013. They also directed Michael Jackson City Tour and Lady Gaga Monster Ball Tour. Okay.
Sometimes he's got those Gaga-isms, we call, you know, taking risks with his fashion choices and...
to say the very least.
Very,
literally an anime character sometimes, how he looks.
Thought is put into every move. He's very... conscious of what he's doing. Everything is deliberate and has intention behind it.
Seems like it, yeah.
Pretty mesmerizing to me.
Oh, yeah.
Really I can't take my eyes off of him.
Mesmerizing is a great word for it. Just to oppress in K-pop. High fashion, composing your own music, rapping, mini album, light stick, gender blending, in closes, coloring, dyeing, air before comeback. Yeah, okay. The composing your music is the one I knew the most. You guys told me it was like Big Bang inspired so many group to do that, basically. Which is obviously awesome. Fashion icon of K-pop. It's slender enough to make everything look cool in his legend. Ozone-S allows for risk that would scare off most dudes, from androgynous hairstyle and makeup to unique sex outfit that the ASAP mob wouldn't dare touch. Complex. Okay. I can only shit about fashion. Either it looks good or it looks goofy to me. Yeah. Oh yeah, he really goes for the... Okay. I don't realize how much he goes for the androgynous vibe. Yeah. Definitely. Definitely. Like, especially there, like, them. I mean... them. Yeah. And some of this look good, some of this look goofy to me. It is what it is. The red is the coolest though. Ponytail, ponytail, that's really good. Mullet, that's surprising. Tom Price Fashion Week in 2012, we made deadline in Cost Frenzy with Street Style Photographer and Fashion Magazine, claimed Best Dressed Natural Style Chameleon. Nalolo. Oh, it's alright. Like, as someone who has the literal same outfit for like years and years, fashion is actually something I care about for myself, but I do like, I love character design, you know, as far as art goes, so I love fashion in that sense. And I do also like cool clothes, so yeah. Yeah, something going on. Fashion Daredevil. Self-fashion figure. Okay. So, once again, ton of work, ton of stuff like that. Fair enough. Don't have as much to say about this than the music, but yeah, go for him. Is he actually a smoker or is he just doing it for the look? I could see him. With what we've learned of him so far, yeah, he's just doing it for the look because, you know, that works with his look. Brands and items that became trendy only because of he wore them. Chromats, which are many, Vans. Don't know any of this. Chanel. Vêtements, that's literally like clothes in French. Vintage t-shirts. Pulp Fiction. Tupac shirt. Okay, okay. Hawaiian shirt. Saint Laurent. Don't let me look at the price. I'm gonna die. GDX channel. PlayStation Global Ambassador for channel. I think that's a perfume brand, no? Okay. Do you know what we do there? Obviously standing out. Exclusive 20 years for Korea anniversary. Calf like Girlfield, instant photograph GD for cover. Alright. Maybe that's the move of vibe, definitely. Like, sometimes, like, there, it looks good in a more, like, normal look. But also like some of the crazy look as well. Also like his mean face, like right there. It is often a look in public, mean face. Apart fashion. Just very low side, but it's a title. Airport fashion, what does that mean? Okay. I mean, okay. I mean, you can tell because he's making it popular, I guess. Makes sense to me. Airport outfit trend. I don't get it. Isn't it just like regular outfits? Like, just outfits? What is it called? Airport fashion? Like, he's just wearing some outfit that he would wear anywhere else? Is it, does he only wear this outfit when he goes to the airport and then he change? Like, some of this just looks like everyday wear, more or less. Like, for, you know, a few thousand everyday wear, but yeah. Interesting. Yeah, I don't know. Damn. I'll call it hiding my face fashion. It's like, leave me the fuck alone fashion. Don't talk to me fashion. Why is photograph looking down? I guess that's a way to avoid anybody talking to him. Otherwise you could never get anywhere. Peace... what was it? Peace Minusune. It's a 16th Dragon launches personal fashion brand. I think I've heard about it in the BIGBANG guide. Peace Minusune. With his long-time stylist, Jiun, as an online store. That only makes sense, obviously. I mean, after like, clearly years of being the translator for fashion, if you just make your own shit and make more money, makes sense. Makes sense. Cap, okay. I mean, like, I don't have much to say about this, it's just brand stuff. Like, this looks like just a black, thing with just the logo on it. To me, it doesn't look very interesting, but it is what it is. Like, when you're a fan of someone, you don't really care. I myself, I'm a fan of a lot of things where I would just buy something with the logo on it because it's them. So, well, it may look so simple, like, you know, you might think it's not worth whatever price it is. It's more about being a fan than anything. Yeah. So, I get it. Mentos. I haven't had a Mentos in a long time. Military service. 2016-2019, Dragon was officially discharged from the military. Yeah, so from 2016 to 2019 he was in, and I guess he wasn't doing anything during that. 3,000 fans attended his discharge ceremony. I mean, that's it, but once again, I'm still surprised that, yeah, like, this massive celebrity making so much money for the country are not exempted. It shows that I guess, even if there's some favoritism for them, like, once they're in, they really, like, take that seriously. You know, everybody does it. I remember, like, as a fan of the UFC, there's a Korean fighter, you know, the Korean zombie. Same thing, like, it was surprising to me that, you know, basically this guy could have been derailed for, like, 3 years, because 3 years in MMA is a long time. And it kind of was, I guess, in a way, with what he's doing now. But, yeah, no, everybody seems to do it. I see there's reason to, I mean, you know, they live next to a country that's quite something. But respect is what I'm saying for like all these artists that actually do it. Yeah. Nike and something. I stopped posing because I don't have as much interest in this section of fashion stuff. I don't really know what to say. Discharge from Italy in 2019, Mikey announced collaboration with G-Dragon's piece Minusune. at work on the Premier Laser upper underneath. So you can draw as well with a draft upper red swoosh. Alright, alright. Now that's some lines, yeah. That's some line. Paran was one white sush was sold out in seconds worldwide for retail price 200. Dragon Knight Air Force One for exclusive white sush is 3000. Okay. Best sneaker, most expensive sneaker. And we did tonight Nike headquarters. Okay. I used to be a fashion guy, I used to wear Nike, but like, you know, 30 bucks Nike. Okay, then the audio is like so vague in this video. I thought there was no audio anymore. Alright, I can't really hear what he's saying. It's fine now. I mean, while I'm not too interested, at the same time I guess that this is like a massive part of him in his life, so, you know, it makes sense to have this in the video. Yeah, definitely. But I'm more in for the music, obviously. As you guys know, Night Frog, Jay Scott, Kenny Clamart, etc. I guess I know those names. GD leaves China too fast. China Aliu Ban. 4 years of Aliu Ban in China. Aliu Ban. First coin artist to endorse in China. Aliu Ban. I don't know what this means. Social title creator. Rookie in 2013. Drake Travis Scott. Well. Retail line. Channel 2015. I don't know. I was about to say that obviously Travis Scott, we know his reputation now. Lily Rose Deep. Kristen Stewart. Kendall Jenner. I mean, most of the people know the name, but obviously it's not my thing. It's not my thing. But, what do you mean, social media campaign? Stevie Wonder. Okay, I know who that is. Queen and King. You see a lot. Jaden Smith. Alright. Fan of Farm, now they are good friends. Nice.
Shout out to G Dragon.
Shout out.
My boy G-Dragon from Korea as well.
Shout out to both
those guys.
Okay.
Fun.
여보세요? Okay.
여보세요? 남자네요?
아, 네, 맞아요.
연수 친구가 잘하는
이 talents. Then if someone, if like I talk to my idol and they're like, do you have any talent? I just, you know, red button, hang up right away. Alright. Yeah, pronunciation, will you? Oof. It's important to have the pronunciation down. GD Young Lol. Okay. For this, you can see it's mostly boys. Okay. It's always not boss. Like with the androgynous thing, I figured it would have like that. You know, a cool fan base. Alright, alright. Damn, this is a fucking line though. I like that they're actually not taking all the coursework, they're letting people bounce. It's correct though. Alright. There's so much stuff that I want to see. Well, like, get a video like this, it makes me realize how much stuff I want to see. Like, not only the songs, but some of the show stuff as well. I recognize the song. At least it sounds like another song. The five? Okay. Catchy vibe. Very catchy vibe. No Korean person who doesn't know which dragon is. Yeah, understandable. I guess he's one of like the biggest name. I wonder if he's like more well known than the president or something. Like, I'm just thinking, I don't even know who the president of Korea is. So, I guess to me, he's more popular. Folder Jiyeon. Not for his manners and humble attitude of stage. Wait, what was that? Folder? Did I read that right? Folder Jiyeon, okay. Humble attitude of stage. Hello, hello. 90 bro, damn. He always boasts 90 degrees because of that VIP gave him nickname Folder Jiyeon. Jiyeon, as when he boils, he folds like a book. Naruto. Alright. I see, I see. Alright. 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 Biggest VIP. I think this one's VIP or VIP. Alright. So, he's into it. Best friend for 20 years. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. 굉장히 이제 서로에 대해서 흉흉봐도 다 알아요.
알지.
저는 진짜로 이게 같이 연습을 하면서 그리고 같이 지내면서 정말 지용이한테 정말 많은 것을 배웠던 것 같아요. 정말 제가 할 수 없었던 일들 그리고 혼자서는 해내가지 못했던 일들을 항상 지용이가 옆에서 힘이 되어줬고.
어서.
어떻게 보면 제가 이 자리에 있던 것도 지용이가 저를 이끌어줬기 때문이라고 저는 생각하고.
Seems like you're singing a bunch of the group I checked out so far, like. There's at least two members that have known each other for like way longer than they've been in a group, so it's pretty cool. Seems to be a thing. Brother Wood, as always, in those groups, more than a brother. Alright. Nice. For getting married. Partying. Alright. Alright. Peace, me have to party in Paris 2017. Alright. Okay, so good friendship. Fair enough. Cake shop still. don't have as much to say about this part. It's interesting though, it's good info. Dada, Ciel. It goes down. One of a camp cast mine safe presence. Alright. Alright. Oh, this sounds good. This song sounds pretty good. I'll stick that one out. Yeah, pretty badass. Alright. Yeah, the video seems like a vehicle here, yeah. And most of them have the same thing going on. They're like somewhat normal or not unnoticeable, but like just not crazy. Outside of stage, but on stage, they're like a different person. Fully in charge of creative process of the music, concert and music video production. Nalodo. Okay, okay. Alright. He looks so serious. Fantastic baby.
It's so incredible watching G-Dragon create and how hands-on he is. I mean, I've never seen an artist who from top to bottom is so hands-on with his own vision and how he's creating exactly what's inside of him, how he's manifesting.
Cool, cool, cool.
Ending 멘트를 어차피 일본어로는 막 진지하게 할 테니까. 다른 나라는 상관없는데.
I don't speak Korean and I don't read Japanese subtitle if there's kanji, so rip. Loves art. He's known for supporting modern art as well as art collector of pieces that was millions.
스코긴 새 작품. 이분은 미국 작가입니다.
네.
Exhibition piece.
만난 적도 없다면서요?
네, 얘기는 나눴고. 이 작가를 처음 택하게 된 이유는 이번 전시회는 대부분 국내 작가분들이 대부분이신데.
예.
그분들은 아무래도 저에 대해서 미리 알.
Designed to enhance people's interest in contemporary art, while interesting rich uncontested art and the pop culture through G-Dragon's collaboration with artists of home and abroad. It is another name for the world perceived and imagined by G-Dragon.
계시겠죠.
Yeah. Interesting.
G-Dragon에 대해서. 근데 저에 대해 전혀 모르는, 그리고 G-Dragon에 대해서 모르는, 인간 관중에 대해서 모르는 작가분들이 저를 표현함에 있어서는 또 다른 작품이 나오지 않을까 하는 설렘에서 시작을 하게 됐어요.
그 저 쭉 이렇게 저희 비디오 월에 다 띄워드렸는데요.
네.
이쪽에 보면
2014년 7일
네.
맨 위에 날짜가 있고 그리고 I can breathe, 난 숨을 쉴 수 없어, 나는 숨을 쉴 수 없어 해서 끝까지.
Today because of G-Dragon as well as STUP, interest in contemporary art in Asia increased especially among young adults.
그리고 이제 작가 이름입니다.
네. Is that art though? It just what I can't raise a bunch of time.
저 작품을
like
보시면 날짜가 써 있는데요.
Yeah.
저 날짜가
you know, just like an horror movie scene.
흑인이라는 이유로 그 뉴욕 경찰에
남겼던
에릭 가너라는 친구가 마지막에 마지막에 했던 남긴 말이 I can't breathe.
Fucking hell. Of course I had to make a joke about this. Of course. So I guess it's a George Floyd situation. I guess George Floyd wasn't the first one. What a surprise!
Yeah.
Well, fuck. I forgot to make a joke.
브리드하고는 어떤 상관이죠?
저 브리드라는 노래가 제 노래 가사예요. 이 스코긴스라는 작가가 제 노래를 들었을 때 에릭건으를 떠올렸었대요.
예.
보시는 것처럼 이 작가의 특징은 보면은
아이들이
장난쳐놓은 낙서 같은 그림인데 안에는 사회적인 메시지를 담고 있는 게 특징이라고 볼 수 있어요.
Artist by nature, he always creating when he's not in the studio, he loves to design, remodel and paint on his clothes. Fair enough. Absolutely, like just endless well of creativity and drive to do something. we shared literally 0.11111% of that motivation. I like doing this time. I use shared on IG, present G-Dragon made for her. Customized the palette album from the inner page to the album cover. Such a great gift, almost divine. I know their friend. He gets to me that IU gave him a feature of alcohol and stuff like that. We see, I've reacted to a song where they collabed. Yeah, cool. Yeah, maybe like a special present like that. That's quite interesting. And once again, art is as subjective as anything can get, so I can't say most of this look too good to me, but it's fine. Clearly, it's just a show of, like, once again, like, the amount of, like, different style of creative stuff he does. It's really insane. Fan meeting. Alright. Damn. Chef dead. during coup d'état promo, G-Dragon filmed music video for Wii U with more than 1,000 of VIPs. G-Dragon asked his fan to film him and what the video would be used for music video. That's interesting, yeah. That's really interesting. And that's when everybody in the audience who has a shitty phone is gonna just cry inside because, you know, your footage isn't gonna be used. Make sure I look good. Alright, Louis just leaves the microphone. What a cool guy. Where's the random kid over there? It's art. I shouldn't question it. That's quite the echo there. But that's a unique performance for the people there, yeah? Alright, it's quite the exclusive event for sure. Teasing them, you do. It just sounds like the more I watch this video, like once again, even if I don't get everything, like some of the fashion or the art, you just have such an aura about him. Like, you know, there's like a ton of massive artists who have so many records and like have done so much and are so big and all that. And when I'm a fan or not, you know, having an aura is something different, I feel like. Like some of them, absolutely massive, to me, they don't feel like they have an aura. And obviously, feeling like someone has an aura is out by being a fan of them. And I guess I'm a fan of G-Dragon now. But it really feels like he has that aura of, you know, like, it's not just his achievement made him special. He has that special vibe as an aura. It's hard to describe. For the reason. Nice. Very close to the audience. Oh my god. Yeah, pretty good. That's the way to get up. Jiyeon confidence in his music, or just sassy G-Dragon.
근데 그거를 한 달에 두 곡씩 몇 달씩 하는 동안에 예를 들면 6월 1일에 발표한 곡은 9월이나 10월 가면 다
잊혀져. Would they lose interest? It's just about if it's like good or not, really. If people like it or not.
저는 자신 있습니다.
I think they would be mad if they get like a song they like every once.
근거는요?
근거요?
예.
아.
Just confident, fair enough. I think, yeah, like, you know, at that point he has earned it, like having crazy confidence, obviously. After like over 10 years of like being the biggest thing, always making absolute hit and everything he's doing working out, clearly, you know, why wouldn't he be confident at this point? Yeah. Yeah. Like, this is mentioning all of his achievements. I wonder, like, any of the stuff he's done, like some music project or some art project, something. Anything he's done has ever failed, like be considered a failure or something, I wonder. But otherwise, yeah, it's obvious that, you know, he's confident because of all the success. The reason I'm just confident,
yeah.
Public like us.
Obviously,
there's the authenticity of them making their own song that helps.
Yeah. 우리가 이 얘기를 이렇게 나누는 순간 네. 엑소와 샤이니의 팬들이 굉장히 화내지 않을까요?
화낼 순 있는데요. 네. 사실이니까 네. 어쩔 수가 없을 것 같아요.
I see that the host of the show is trying to start some shit. Yeah, I don't think he said like, you know, we're better because we make our own music and the group that have someone make the music for them are shit. I don't think that's what G-Dragon said. Clearly that presentator was trying to start shit.
무척 당당하신 것 같습니다.
만드니까요.
예, 네. 만든다는 게 굉장히 중요한 건가 보죠.
중요 안 할 순 없을 것 같아요. 왜냐하면 예. 가수라는 직업은 제가 예를 들어 어떤 작곡가 분의 노래를 받아서 부른다면은
예.
글쎄 저는 개인적으로 자신감이 없어요. 왜냐하면 다른 분들은 어떨지 모르지만 저는 예. 표현하는 방법을 어렸을 적부터 제가 만든 노래를 제가 표현하는 방법.
It's interesting subject. Like I used to only listen to metal for the most part. And obviously, like, there's no someone else write your songs, everybody write their own song, more or less. So for me, like, you know, my take was, yeah, if, like, all those artists on TV, like, pop, that get someone else to write that song, that's shit. That's what I used to think. And it took a while to change that mentality, like, especially now that I got into, like, Japanese Idol and now K-pop and stuff like that. Like, I stopped giving shit about singing like that. All I care about now is if I like it or not, frankly. Now, it's sure there's, like, some song that have, I wouldn't say less of an impact, but knowing that the person performing it didn't write it might feel a bit lesser than when, you know, you have like a really deep song written by someone and they're performing it. But nonetheless, at this point, I'm just like, good music is good music. I don't give a shit. I used to have that dumb mentality of like, yeah, once again, if it's not written by the person, it's like shit. Jugan was accused of plagiarism by Sony Music as his track, Heartbreaker, was thought of to be similar to Florida's Right Around. Okay, let's see it. Show us the comparison.
그 또 솔로 앨범 하트메이커 이게 또 표절 시비에 또 휘말립니다. 여기에 대해서는
한 번도 방송.
The originality of the Dragon Sun question should be determined in court, and that YG will wait for response for original rights on Sun producer. Yeah, fair enough, obviously. I don't know. I haven't told boss. I thought we were going to be shown boss.
표절건에 대해서 말을 한 적이 없었던 것 같아요. 근데 듣는 사람에 따라 귀도 틀리고 생각하는 범위도 틀리고 느끼는 점들도 다 틀리기 때문에
EME was the right to write on stated the similarity between the two songs. I mean, you know, there's so much music out there. Everything will sound similar. And sometimes you would, like, it's very likely that you can make a song and subconsciously without thinking about it, just like, yeah, you know, think of another song and that's how it ends. That's very possible.
틀리다 이렇게 정할 수는 없지만 이것 또한 다음부터는
On March 6, 2010, YG announced that they had personally contacted Florida's representative and that Florida will appear as a featured artist in a new version of Heartbreaker to be released as a bonus track on G-Dragon's live album China Light. Yeah, I know Florida is not a dick. I used to like one of his songs back when it was on TV like 10 years ago when I was young. And then I looked at some stuff about him and he seemed like a good guy, so I'm not surprised. I wouldn't say I like his music, I like that one song back then, but like it was on TV all the time.
Hmm.
따로 이제 왈가불가 이렇게 글로 쓴다기보다는 다음 앨범 이제 다음 무대에서 음악이나 무대로 보여주는 게
그렇지 않다는 걸 보여주는 게
할 수 있는 일이라고 생각이 됐기 때문에 그냥 조용히 묵묵히 다음 앨범 열심히 준비했던 것 같아요.
My man has enjoyed a song. There's one song that sounds like another one. So listener is like, money, give me money. 8, 21 years old, Jiyoung received in 29, 2010. What?
아이고, 이건 나도 좀 견디기 힘들었다 이런 댓글도 있습니다.
하나하나 상처가 굉장히 많이 됐었던 것 같아요. 부모님들께 전화도 많이 피하게 됐던 것 같고 친구들 전화도 안 받게 된 것 같고 사람들을 이렇게 본다는 게 굉장히 되신 게 없지만 죄신 것 같은 느낌이 들더라고요. 좀 우울증 아닌 우울증이 있었던 것 같은데 다른 말들은 그분들의 생각이니까 그분들의 생각을 듣는 한에서 이렇게 끝낼 수 있는 문제였는데
비판이니까
예 비판이니까 네. 말 그대로
예
이런 분들 있잖아 자살해라 그냥
애식
그런 말들은 밑도 끝도 없으니까요 정말 말 그대로
네 알겠어
내가 저분에게 이렇게 생각하게끔 만든 일이 뭐가 있을까 이런 생각에 많이 좀 빠졌던 것 같아요.
Limb amputation petition. What the fuck, dude? Kwon Jiyoung suicidal signature seeking campaign. We're on and collecting thousands of signatures. I mean, I'm not really shocked or anything. I've been on the internet for a long time, so I'm not really shocked. But damn, obviously, like whether you're like the most massive, like popular superstar like G-Dragon. Or just me, you're gonna get something like that. I've only been told once to go die. So I've been lucky so far, but I'm still like so small, obviously. I guess the bigger you get, the more you run into that kind of people, obviously. I mean, the classic thing is say ignore it. It's sometimes easier said than done. Obviously, like, you know, thousands of signatures, like, you know, even if you got 50,000 signatures, it's like 0.1% of his fans. So in a way, you could say like it means nothing. But we all know as content creator and like public figure in some sense that sometimes even just like if I read my comment section, it's like, you know, there's 50 good comments and one comment either being just mean for a reason or like criticizing me by something that I actually can agree with. I still feel bad more about that one comment than the supportive comment. Sometimes it'd be like that. It is always easier said than done to like only take the positive as far as like ignore the just non-constructive dumb comments or just if you take criticism, take it just well. It's like easier said than done all the time. Obviously, once again, I'm talking on a different level of popularity, but yeah. Obviously, I do reaction videos, so you guys have been shut down a lot for that. But only one time I got told today. For stealing people's content.
할 일이고 내가 항상 꿈꿔왔던 일이면 내가 감수해야 될 몫이라고 생각하니까 마음이 좀 오히려 놓이다 보니까 멤버들이랑도 굉장히 많은 도움을 받았고 이런 거에 휘둘리기보다는 조금 더 크게 생각해서 내 음악을 듣고 조금 더 꿈을 꾸고 조금 더 이렇게 마음이 놓일 사람들이 더 많기 때문에 제가 흔들리면 안 된다고 생각을 했었던 것 같아요.
Fair enough, yeah. He's strong. Really nice that he's talking about stuff like that. Not just in a song, for example, but like, yeah, on a show like that, yeah. Quite honest, the guy. Legacy.
뭐 항상 제가 좋아하는 아티스트라든지 물론 지금은 다들 고인이 되신 분들이라든지 그런 분들의 다큐멘터리 같은 짧은 영상들을 찾아보면 근데도 보면 왠지 그게 20년 전, 30년 전의 필름이지만 되게 뭔가 그 안에 많은 진리가 담겨져 있다는 느낌을 이상하게 받게 돼요. 굉장히 짧은 말인데.
그래서
그런 게 뭘까 저도 생각을 항상 많이 해봤어요. 이런 촬영들을 할 때 이런 게 계속 기록이 되고 내가 살아있는 동안 계속해서 열심히 잘 살아서 사람들 머릿속에
You want to be remembered.
기억이 된다면 내가
And inspire.
죽고 나서도 그 후에 다음 세대들이 이런 영상을 볼 때 무슨 생각을
yeah. I see, I see.
하면서 볼까 어른이 돼간다는 게 저는 조금 잘 못하는
Forever Young.
이게 마음 말처럼 쉽지가 않은
It is.
세상을 살아가다 보면 부딪힐 일도 많고 본의 아니게 뭔가 겪어야 될 일도 많고 그렇게 하다 보니까 그냥 다른 거 신경 쓰지 말고 하루하루 매 순간 재밌게
Enjoy your life. Except for some reason, when listening to this part of my head is empty. Damn.
잘하고 있고 잘 다 잘 될 거야. 네가 그렇게 만들고 있어.
Yeah.
근데. 너도 좀
should rest too. Fair enough.
그런 식으로 왔던 것 같아. 널 위해 살아.
It seems wise as hell, honestly. 세상이
무너지진 않아. 다 알아서 돌아갈 건 돌아가. 자연을 보렴. 인간은 정말 작은 존재란다.
Well, it do be like that. Don't be dramatic, as you just think the most dramatic shit.
일단 올해만 버텨보자. Good.
I see. The end. All right. Okay. Well. That is definitely what I call an in-depth look. Damn, that's pretty interesting. Obviously, I don't have too much to say about the fashion part or the art part, for example. Like, interesting, pretty cool that he's into that and doing all that kind of stuff. Really, I'm only getting a fan of him for like the music. I don't think I'll ever have any interest as I've never had into like, his cruising stuff or like that. But yeah, for the music, yeah. I think it just shows that one thing is like, he's an artist overall. It's like just not just music. It's like so many things that he's into, can do, and will do. And I think that's pretty awesome. Just respect, once again, like, I think it will be great now that I've watched this. When I check out some of his songs, I would have much more, like, have an understanding on why, like, he made this song or, like, what it might mean by something. And just respect for the artistry and everything he puts into it, for sure. No, it's really a legend, once again. I think watching this kind of video in advance is just perfect for appreciating everything even more so. Yeah, it was great to watch. Is there anything I wanted to touch on? Not really. I mean, it was a good video. Definitely, like, you know, I wish I didn't have to pause every 2 seconds because it's literally too fast. I feel like even most people couldn't video this too fast sometimes. But I guess it's an older video, and these people are still making like a BIGBANG guide up to today. So I'm sure they've improved. So they have like guide for the other members, I guess. So I checked out this one, which was their first video. Okay, that makes a lot more sense, yeah. Yeah, so then they have guide for like every member, which I've read as you. I guess they're not as popular as the Dragon. Yeah. Then people behind Big Bang, and then just a bunch of Big Bang video. And then the other interesting thing is this, in-depth guide to Big Bang, part 1, 2006-2008, then part 2. So they really seem like they're going to go deep into Big Bang. So maybe I'll check that out. Once again, I'll only do all of this if you guys want me to check it out. So you just tell me. If you want me to check out the big guide to any of the other members, or this in-depth guide, you just let me know. And I might do it. But yeah, interesting video. I'd leave a comment. I'll leave a comment. Really interesting video. Alright. And so yeah, once again, it doesn't mean that I'm gonna like everything that you get from him. I still keep doing my stuff, you know, it's like honest reaction, I guess. I don't call it like that like some people do. You feel like if you watch a reaction video, you'd like to expect honest reaction, but yeah. I might not like everything, but you know, I'm sure I'm gonna like some stuff because clearly it's got quite the aura about him. Okay, so link in the description for the original video, the link to his channel. link to my Twitter, Discord, Twitch, and Bilibili, well, this channel, this person's channel, Bilibili, my streaming event. As always, thanks for watching, like and subscribe, and see you guys next time. See ya!